Hi, I'm Yannis Roussos, the product manager for the Memory Group, and I'd like to take you through what we're planning to achieve in GitLab 40.7, which is scheduled to be released on January 22nd of 2022. It's the end of the year, so this is going to be a shorter milestone for us. To start with, we want to wrap up any remaining tasks for our top two initiatives during the past few milestones. Let me recap. The first one is creating a Redis instance for session keys. This is very important for a large instance like GitLab.com, where we want to further scale Redis persistent by partitioning it and moving session keys to a separate Redis instance. We are almost done, a few steps away from finishing this the rollout plan and migrating all the data and start using the second Redis that we have created. The second one is updating the way we export Sidekick metrics to use a separate process. This is very useful because it makes collecting and emitting Sidekick related metrics more stable, and at the same time prevents edge cases that have resulted in metrics related data loss in the past. It's also the base in which we are going to build on top to also update the way we emit and export metrics from Puma in future milestones. This is almost ready, but we are not going to release it on 40.7 because there may be some instances, GitLab instances out there that have changed the default ports for Sidekick health checks and metrics, and they will have to update the configuration file, their configuration, otherwise this will be a breaking change. For that reason, we're going to add the deprecation warning on 14.7 and release this update in 15.0. Back to our planning for 14.7. Our next top priority is to go back to our work on performance related tooling. So we are a performance focused group. We want to enable every GitLab team member to make data-driven decisions and understand performance-related issues. That requires sharp tooling and clear, simple to understand performance guidelines. This is an internal-facing initiative, but we think that it's a very important one and very close to our mission as a group, because by doing so, and at the same time, by automating and shifting left performance profiling, we will be able to identify performance issues earlier, and one MR at a time, we will be able to make GitLab more performant for all GitLab users. We will start with consolidating our profiling tools, because we have more than a few different profiling tools that we are using, identifying the use cases each profiling tool is useful for, and also improve our documentation guidelines around performance practices. Depending on our capacity, we may work on additional tooling related issues, but this will depend on how the milestone will go. Our next top priority is to instrument tracking of application boot time. We have internal reports coming from our Kubernetes infrastructure that indicate that GitLab may be taking a little bit more than expected to start, even too long to start. We want to collect data from both GitLab.com and self-managed instances about how long it actually takes GitLab to boot in different environments. Because this is related to a few performance initiatives that we want to work on, and having metrics on this performance vector will help us drive further decisions forward. So, because every time we have to instrument metrics, this requires a full release cycle for us to start getting data back. We want to work on that and release it on 40.7 so that we can start getting data back early February and help us decide on our next initiatives going forward. Finally, we want to revisit composable code base. This is an epic, something that the team has worked a year ago. Composable code base is the way we talk about splitting the GitLab application into functional parts. Think about them as application layers to make sure that only needed code is loaded. So we have worked a year ago and we have run a proof of concept. This is a very large initiative, but it can have a few significant results and performance improvements for GitLab. So it could lower the memory usage. It can shorten the application load time for different components. It can shorten garbage collection. It can lead to shorter garbage collection cycles. It can improve the responsiveness of Sidekick, of Sidekick service, and much more. But it still is a pretty large initiative with no clear outcomes yet, even though we have run a proof of concept. So our focus during 40.7 will be to create an actionable plan together with a rollout plan in phases and make sure to identify and clearly define the impact and the performance benefits that we're going to have with each rollout phase. This can end up with us saying that it's not worth going after this very big problem, or it may end up being our big next big initiative and for both the memory group and other groups of GitLab, if we decide that this can help a lot with memory consumption and other performance characteristics of GitLab. I will have more information on that on the planning video, on the kickoff video for 40.8. Thank you for watching and talk to you next year.